Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. My brothers and sisters, this evening I want to bring to you an amazing story about how I met someone so special 30 years later. I take you back to 30 years ago when I was accepted to study at the University of Medina. And subhanallah, I got my visa, I got everything done. And the ticket kept delaying. They said it will be issued next week, etc., etc., by the airline. And so the visa was about to expire. This is 30 years ago. My father told me, why don't we buy you a one-way ticket? And inshallah, you will get a refund when you go there. You can ask them, explain to them what happened. And inshallah, they will give you the refund. And that's exactly what we did. So when I arrived at the university, mashallah, everything was so different. It was a unique experience. Medina Munawwara, the excitement of being in Medina together with the difficulty of the heat and many other challenges. And one of the challenges was to get a refund for the 1,200 riyal that was actually spent on the ticket because it was supposed to have been given by the university, but there was a delay. So I decided to ask for it. I wrote a little application and I went to the various departments. Trust me, it took so long. From one department to another, they sent me here, they sent me there. And to visit these departments, you had to go there during your free time when it was not time for studies. And that was just during the break, which is very short, and then you've got to go and come back. So it was very frustrating. And about 3 or 4 months of this up and down, achieving nothing, I then decided, subhanAllah, one of my friends told me, why don't you go and see who is known as Ra'is al-Jami'ah, you know, the vice chancellor of the university. And he was someone whom we hadn't known, obviously. We just knew, okay, this is the vice chancellor. He used to be called Ra'is at the time. Now they are called Mudir. But the Ri'asa of the Jami'ah, we actually went to see this man. I went to see this man. And I remember his office, it was so unique because everything was quiet. It was in a building on its own. And going there, myself being a new student, you know, Zimbabwean, and I ended up going into the door. Knocked on the door. In fact, the door was open, but I just knocked on it and I entered the door, greeted him. And I started explaining to him in English, you know, I'm a new student. And, you know, he said, wait, calm down. Because obviously I was walking very fast, panting. I still recall it very vividly. And so he said, do you speak Arabic? I said, yes. But he said, so speak in Arabic. He made sure that I spoke in Arabic, not in English, even though he knew the English language. But I spoke and I explained to him, you know, I've been having a problem. I came on my own account, you know, with my own ticket, and I need the refund for the ticket. And I've been going from office to office, and they're sending me literally from pillar to post and whatnot. And I just finished explaining to him, saying, "Look, I'd like you to assist me in this regard, you know, to get this." He told me, "How much is the amount?" I told him 1,200 riyal. He took his wallet out of his pocket. He took out 1,200 riyals. He gave it to me and said, "There you go." So I said, subhanallah, problem solved. You know, it changed my whole perspective and understanding. It created ease within split seconds. I was calm. Every problem that I had seemed minor. Not to say this was a major issue, but as a student coming from, you know, far off, and every penny means a lot. And subhanAllah, here was a man who just told me, no, what's the amount? Okay, here it is, take it and go. You know? And I was like, wow, subhanAllah. I prayed for this man. His name was Sheikh Abdullah Al-Ubaid. And what happened is, I didn't see him after that. I saw him a few times in some of the lessons and just in passing, but never managed to greet him or talk to him. And I studied there and I completed my studies. And I've known that he left the university. He was given a higher post and then he became a member of the Shura and he became a minister and a minister of education and so many other things. And I always used to see him and feel in my heart, this man is a good man. He's helped me, and say a prayer for him. And, you know, he created a lot of ease for me when I was in need. And subhanAllah, what happened at Taraweeh? I just happened to enter this place where I was making Salat al-Taraweeh, and I saw a man walking towards me, elderly man. I mean, must be about 80 years old now, I think. And subhanAllah, I looked at him, and immediately my heart was so calm and cool. I recognized him. Someone tried to introduce me to him to say, Salaamu Alaikum, this is Sheikh. I said, wait, hang on. I said, Sheikh, and in the Arabic language, I told him, Sheikh, I have a story to tell you. He said, the story. I said, a story that happened between me and you, and I want to narrate it to you. So he said, what's the story? In a nutshell, I told him, years back, this is what you did. He said, I don't even remember. Subhanallah. And I told him, I never will forget this deed. I never will forget the goodness, the way I felt. I never will forget what happened on that particular day. No one knew what was going to happen 30 years down. And so, mashallah, we sat and we spoke, and it was just so amazing. And I felt a deep connection. And this is the man, mashallah, Sheikh Abdullah Al-Ubaid, Ma'ali Al-Ustadh. Doctor, Ma'ali Doctor Abdullah Al-Ubaid, Hafizahullah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect him, grant him good health, give him and his family members and all his loved ones goodness in this world and the next. May Allah reward him abundantly. Like he told me, I don't remember this story at all, but I'm telling it to you. A friend of mine who studied with us at the same time, when I sent him the photograph of myself and Dr. Abdullah, he told me, isn't this the guy who gave you the money from his own wallet? I said, that's the man, mashallah. So he knew the story. I know it may sound, like it's something small, but wallahi, it was a major thing. It was something that literally restored faith in the system or the people, you know, around us. Sometimes you feel very lonely, alone. And those who help us, subhanAllah, we never forget them. May Allah continue to use us to help others in a similar way. May Allah bless this man, like I said, and may Allah grant him Jannatul Firdaus. May Allah grant him successes and his progenies. And not just him, but anyone who has helped others and those who reach out to those in need. May Allah make me from among those who reach out to others. And may Allah grant all of us Jannatul Firdaus. I thought this was a very, very amazing boost for all of us, because it's Ramadan, 30 years later, and I'm talking about something that happened, and Allah just refreshed all of it just by me seeing this man walking in. I said, subhanAllah, this is the man. And I've always meant to tell him, hey, you know what, I really love you for the sake of Allah. And I really remember the day I was a nobody, I was a nothing, I was unknown, I was a new student, I could barely speak Arabic in the sense that, you know, I didn't know much. And subhanAllah, here goes. This man was just, he just said, what was the amount? And here it was, sorted out and solved. Sometimes in our lives, Allah puts us in a position where it is very easy for us to assist others, but we don't intentionally. We make life difficult for them purposely, as though we are gaining a joy by delaying them or hassling them, troubling them. That is criminal. We should never do that. If Allah has given you ease, you should help the people. You should make life easy for them. If Allah has put you in a position of authority of any sort, whether it happens to be a managerial post, whatever else it may be, remember to treat those below you with utmost respect. Make life easy for them. Allah will grant you. They will remember you. They will pray for you without you knowing for years, for decades to come. They will continue praying for you and your family. And even though they may not know the broader loved ones of yours, but they would actually pray. So remember this. If you are to make life difficult, they would have remembered you for something bad, for something harsh. I'm sure there are people in our lives we wouldn't ever like to see them again. And there are others we pray to Allah that He allows us to cross paths so that we can just greet each other. I love you, my brother, my sister, for the sake of Allah Almighty. You've really, really helped me a lot. And that's it. Nothing more. So my brothers and sisters, let's pray for one another. Very interesting 10 minutes of a boost. May Allah grant us Jannatul Firdaus. أقول قولي هذا وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد.